Hello students, in the last class we have discussed about the sources of energy and we have discussed about many sources and we have classified them as renewable and non-renewable. Today we will be studying about fuels. Fuels are defined as a chemical which releases energy when heated with oxygen. Means whenever any fuel or any chemical which is considered as a fuel, or we can say that if any chemical on combustion gives energy, then it is known as a fuel. But the energy which is released on the burning of fuel, it is in the form of heat and light. So we define it as now there are some categories which or there are some features which a fuel must satisfy to be a good fuel. So features of good fuel are first, it should be easily available and cheap. Next, it should be easy to handle and safe to transport. Means there should be no danger in handling the fuel and it should be safe to transport. Next, it should have high calorific value. Calorific value is defined as the amount of heat which is produced by burning a unit mass of a fuel completely in air. If we have a 1 gram of any fuel substance and it is burnt completely in the open environment, where there is a lot of amount of oxygen. So the amount of heat, means the temperature or the energy which is given to that fuel to burn, is its calorific value. So it should be high for any fuel to be a good fuel. And last, it should have proper ignition temperature. Means ignition temperature is defined as the temperature at which any fuel catches heat readily. So if it is low, then that fuel cannot be used even at room temperature, because it may catch fire easily being its low ignition temperature. And it should not be high enough, because if it is high, then we have to supply a large amount of heat to burn it. So it should be proper, neither high nor low. So these are the four important features which any fuel, to be a good fuel, has to be satisfied. Now, the fuels are categorized into various categories on the basis of the state of their availability. Means the state in which they are available to us. On the basis of it, they are classified into three categories. First is solid, liquid, and gaseous. As we have said that these are classified on the basis of the state of their availability. So the solid fuels are the fuels which are available in the solid form. For example, we can take wood, charcoal. These are fuels and are present in the solid form. Similarly, the fuels which are present in liquid form are known as liquid fuels. For example, petrol, methanol, and the fuels which are present in the gaseous state are known as gaseous fuels. For example, natural gas, coal gas, and many others.